Today we're going to look at polymerization of epoxy resin using the microwave and the multitask beam capsule holder. The microwave will be the EMS 9000. It's an 825 watt microwave, and we use it primarily for our processing run, but also for rapid polymerization. As we look inside, I have the water that I preheated to 60 degrees C for our processing, and then also the temperature probe in the back. I'll be doing it for 1 hour and 15 minutes at 60 degrees C at 80% power. And that's 80% of our 825, so that's 660 watts if you want to convert it to whatever wattage your microwave might be. So to get started, we're going to take a look at the multitask embedment for polymerization of epoxy resin. You can use it in a regular oven as well, but I use it for our rapid polymerization. In this step, we'll be able to do our full polymerization in 3 hours. We simply take the top of it off, and let's take a look at the inside of it. It looks like a typical beam capsule holder for 00 beam capsules. A variety of number of slots, and then our top is going to go on it, and that's going to compress it down with the top caps on our beam capsules. We don't have to worry about water getting into it. So I like to start with my beam capsules in the regular holder so I don't get any resin on the insertion of the multitask. So when I fill these up, I want to be sure, like normal, we don't get bubbles in there and things, typical for even oven polymerization. But I also don't want to overfill it, because normally for oven polymerization, I don't put the cap on it. And so if I overfill it and then I'm going to put the cap on it, it can get messy. So just be careful with that. So I'm going to do 4 of these and then put them into the holder. Now, the beauty of this multitask holder is that I don't have to worry about wrapping them up with parafilm or putting parafilm in the top of it and things like that so that the water doesn't get into our beam capsules. So I'm just going to put the caps on it, and again, I don't have to worry about the parafilm or whatever you might use to inhibit water from getting into your resin. Be sure to separate your beam capsules out. Don't put them all in one place. That way then the cap will, or the top will sit evenly on the holder. So I'm just going to put them in and separate them nicely so that when I put the top on, it's going to fit down nice and snug and evenly. If I put them all on one side, then it would sit lopsided. So when we tighten this down, you want to give it a good tighten. You don't want to get a wrench and do that, but you don't want to over tighten or under tighten. So I've found there's a lot of leeway, but I like to make it a little bit tighter than looser. So again, I've preheated the water to 60 degrees C. Otherwise, it's going to take a lot longer for that amount of water to heat up. And we just put that in there. And you can always check, make sure there's enough water in there to immerse your samples. So we're doing 1 hour, 15 minutes, 80% power, 60 degrees C. Comes out to be 660 watts. We're going to check on that, and again, 1 minute is counting, 1 hour and 15 minutes is counting down now, our 60 degrees C. So after this is done, I need to do another secondary polymerization. The 60 degrees for 1 hour and 15 minutes isn't enough. So now I'm going to do 1 hour, 45 minutes, 90% power, 85 degrees centigrade, which comes out to be 745 watts. So I'm going to check that, and I see now I have 1 hour and 30 minutes in there, and it should be 1 hour and 45 minutes. I'm going to change that as soon as I'm done here. I have 85 degrees C, 90% power. Again, that relates to the wattage of your microwave. And now we're going to get going. Let me change that number again. And so now here we're down. It's been an hour and almost 45 minutes. We're all set. And I'm going to remove this and check on our polymerization. Now be careful, the water is hot. So it is 85 degrees, so be careful. And all we have to do is take our unit out of the bath. And I just have a pair of tweezers and then supporting that with a pair of scissors. And then let's take a look at the polymerization of our blocks. Again, we processed the tissues for 3 hours with a little bit of extra infiltration. I never cheat on that. And 3 hours for our polymerization, we're looking at a total of 6 hours from raw tissue to fully polymerized blocks and ready for microtomy. The resin is nice and hard. You can't get your fingernail into it just a little bit. And so it looks like it's a very good polymerization.